guys and girls, welcome back to Watch the Time. So today I'm featuring a Chronos. It's their Subby Homage. This is the sort of more upgraded version. They've gone for the sort of glide style lock clasp. They sort of homage from Rolex. I've wanted to get this in for a while. I've seen a lot of people waxing lyrical about this watch. So again, there's a couple of reasons I got this. And one, I wanted to review it. I wanted to see if all the hype was real. And two, I've got the San Martin Water Ghost version 2, which for me, that was the one I liked the most. And my one in particular is done very, very well. Very, very nice. So I thought we could run the two head to head, get big boys on the block. Again, 12 rounds to see who comes out on top eventually with these two. But look out for that video in the future. But for now, we're just going to be going through the stats and specs and the pants and pucker and seeing if it really does measure up. Because for me, on AliExpress, there's lots of Subby homages about, but I still don't think anyone's toppled San Martin. From my mind, I just don't think they have. I like the fact they've gone for a glide lock style clasp. How good is it? We'll see. But in terms of the overall watch, yeah, I'll go through what I think about it now. But please keep an eye out for the head-to-head. That should be quite tasty. I do appreciate your support and for tuning back in. And without further ado, let's get the camera turned around and get on with it. Hi, guys and girls. So this is the watch. Do bear with me. I've tried recording a couple of times now and I keep having a sneezing fit. So hopefully it doesn't break out again. But hopefully this time, about fourth time lucky. So just open the box up. As I said in the brief intro, it's the Chronos. It's a sub homage. This is the packet, sort of packaging that came around the watch. I went for the green one, also known as sort of like the Hulk. A few different bits and pieces. They give you an extra screw because there's screw pins on the bracelet. It comes with a warranty card, and the warranty card is signed, as you'll see. And it comes with a couple of nice tools, actually. Screwdriver, bracelet sizing removal tool. And I've had to take a couple of links out for it to fit myself. But let's pop all that back away, and we can look at the watch. The model number for this watch is L6005. It's their Subby homage, as I've said. Not a lot of originality going on here, but yeah, they produced a nice watch. Inside, it's running an automatic PT5000 movement. It's not an exhibition case back, so you won't be able to see anything. It's just high polished on there, so it's not going to show you anything. But it's a PT5000 movement, a movement I'm actually becoming quite enamored with. I actually quite like it. The case, so the construction of this, aside from the insert, let me just wipe the crystal, is all stainless steel. So that is the bezel, aside from the insert, the crown, case back, case, solid end links, bracelet and clasp, all 316L stainless steel. The case thickness of this watch is 13.3 millimeters. That does become 14.5 millimeters, including the Cyclops. The case diameter, going from the 8 to the 2, is 41.6. When you go from the 9 to the 3, including the crown, it does become 44.7 millimeters. The lug width on this is 20 millimeters, and the lug to lug tip to tip is 48 millimeters. That does become 51.2, as you have male center links of the end link, so that does sort of protrude, sort of just almost four mil or 3 mil on top of the normal lug width or lug length even. The case back, as I've already showed you, is a screw down case back, sterile, very much in keeping with the watch that it's homaging. The bezel is a ceramic bezel, as I've already alluded to, and I'll let you listen to it. Pretty consistent clicks, a little bit of wobble and bounce in it, not as firm as my San Martin, and quite light to touch. Whether that's a good thing or not, I'm not sure. The crown is situated at 3 o'clock, and it is signed, as you'll be able to see just there. Sorry about my fingerprints, guys. The strap material that it comes on is the strap. It comes with stainless steel, excuse me. It is all fully brushed. Very, very nice brushing, actually. Probably a satin brush, polished on the sides, and you can see the screw pins. That sort of continues with the case, actually. Top of the case is brushed, the sides are polished. So very consistent in terms of how the bracelet is with the case. The clasp is fully milled, Very much in keeping again with the watch that it's homaging, and it does come with a glide style lock clasp, so you can sort of just I'm gonna turn it around for you very quickly. As you can see, just in there, it will allow you to adjust on the fly, so you can get better fit, or if you're having a hot day, you can make it a bit looser, and so on and so forth. But yeah, that's the bracelet, that's the clasp. The crystal covering that dial is sapphire crystal. I'm sure you kind of would expect that now, given Chronos is quite a reputable brand on AliExpress as opposed to some of the others. So yeah, sapphire crystal, as is the Cyclops, because I also tested that. The water resistance, you might be able to see down at the six, is 200 meters. So that would give you 20 atmospheres of water resistance. And the weight will appear in the top right hand corner. It's in around 150 grams. Give or take. But let's have a look at the dial now, guys, in a bit more detail. So what you have, you've got a minute track going around the outer edge. Just inside that, you've got applied battens everywhere except for the 3 o'clock position, making way for the date window. At the 12, you've got an inverted triangle. At the 6 and 9, you've got a double batten, quite a big large one. Everywhere else, you've got circular indices applied, and the hands are very much again in keeping with the Rolex Subby Homage look. Mercedes style hands, lollipop on the end or near the end of the second hand. Also, just below there, let me unscrew the crown so you can have a look at the dial in a bit more detail. It's sort of like a matte sort of green color. Let me get it to sort of 8:20, which is where I normally put it. The dial looks quite nice, not exactly the same as the bezel in terms of color, but it works not too bad. Just like I said, below the inverted triangle at the 12, you've got Chronos applied in sort of like block capitals. And just above the batten at the 6, you've got automatic 200 meters, 660 feet in script writing that's been printed onto the dial. As you can see, at the 3 o'clock position, you have a date window, make way for the PT5000. And it has got a Cyclops. I dare say it doesn't look like it's magnifying 2.5 times. That looks like a max of 1.5 times to me. And the movement is a good movement, high beat movement. It's a Chinese clone of the Salita or the Eta. I can't remember which one, but yeah, very, very nice. You take it out to the first position, you'll be able to scroll through the dates. If you take it all the way out, you can hack it. And let me just put it to 10:10 now to complete the look of the dial. But yeah, that's the dial, guys. Do the crown up a little bit. But yeah, that's the dial. Excuse me, guys, I've got a bit of a cold. As you can see, they've got a bit of blue AR coating on that crystal as well. I don't know if it was slated as having clear AR coating, but it definitely looks like blue to me. But let me just pop it on the wrist for you guys, give you an idea of what it looks like on my wrist. My wrist is just above a 7-inch wrist for your reference. And as you saw at the start, I did have to take out two links, and I'm sort of 2/3 of the way into the micro adjustment. And that's what it looks like on me. As I say, my wrist is just above a 7-inch wrist, and it conforms to the wrist quite nicely, actually. You'd have seen that on the intro where I showed it in daytime conditions as well. Not bad at all. But now that'll take me on to what I think is pants and pucker about the watch. And if you've ever watched before, you know I always start with pants. I like to go on a high with pucker. So what I think is pants. Yeah, I'd say the Cyclops, to be honest, guys. If it's going to be that useless, it doesn't really need to be there. It doesn't really make it any bigger, to be honest. If you look underneath, it's not tiny, so it's only magnifying it a slight amount. So the Cyclops is a bit of a letdown. The logo on the dial, I don't know why they've done it in such a way where it's sort of underlined and it's joined in with the block capitals. I'd rather it not been like that. Just block capitals would have done me no problem. I do prefer it to the sort of cartoony sort of writing they had before, but I would have preferred it not to be underlined personally. The bezel, a little bit of bounce and back play, not on the same level as the San Martin Water Ghost version 2 that I have, but I will do a head-to-head with that in the future if that's something that is appealing to you guys. So yeah, the bezel, bit of bounce, bit of back play, and just a little bit lighter than I would like on my bezel. The crown engagement, as you can see, I didn't do it all the way up simply because it's a bit of a nightmare, to be honest. It's a bit of a nightmare to really deal with when you put it back in terms of screwing it back up is not the easiest. A little bit tighter than I would have liked as well with the engagement on the crown. And the indices at the six, I don't know if you're going to pick up on this on camera, but the indices is a little bit tilted to the left. It's not straight, which is unfortunate. It's something I picked up on quite early when I was looking at the watch. The indices definitely tilts over to the left a bit more than it should. Which is a bit of a shame. Other than that, not bad. But yeah, they're the things I think are pants for now. So let me just surmise. I'd go with the Cyclops with the magnification on there, the logo on the dial, the bezel, the crown engagement, and the indices at the six in terms of what I think is pants. What I think is pucker is I'd go with the sapphire crystal. I do like sapphire crystal on my watches. The movement is cool. PT5000. I do quite like that. I've got it in a few of my watches at this point. The loom's actually pretty good, guys. Actually, you see that when I did the close-ups with my with the dial and stuff, I would have spliced in some a loom shot for that. The clasp, yeah, finished very, very well. Actually, nice brush finished, nice duck glide lock style on there, sort of mimicking the Rolex itself. And the fit and finish in terms of the polishing, the brushing, the tolerances, it is put together nicely. I'm not gonna lie, it's not what I thought it would be. But it's still put together nice and it's a cool watch. So just to surmise what I think is pucker, I would go with the sapphire crystal, the movement, the loom, the clasp, and the fit and finish in terms of what I think is pucker. And would I recommend this watch? I probably would, but if I'm being brutally honest, the clasp was a nice addition, but the watch overall itself, I must say, I think the San Martin is a better proposition personally. I still have the San Martin version 2, and like I said, I will do a head-to-head if that's something that's interesting to you guys. But maybe my expectations were a little bit unrealistic. I'm not sure, but yeah, I kind of hoped for a bit more given the noise that I've been making about this watch. I've been a little bit disappointed. Still a very good watch, don't get me wrong. But if it was a choice, if I had to buy one on AliExpress, a Subby Homage, I'd probably still go for San Martins personally, but that's just subjective. But guys, let me know what you think about this watch and maybe any other watches you may want to see on the channel. And as always say, don't forget to like and subscribe and always watch the time. Take care, guys. All the very best.